We want to welcome you here to our second sheep show of our second week of judging sheep here at the Big E. We're glad to have you in the barn and enjoying our show this afternoon. We have 35 head of sheep from various different breeds that are going to be competing here for prizes and honors at our Big E. We do have 8 different exhibitors. We have entries here from several different states. Again, with 35 entries, and as far west as Illinois and Indiana will be competing here today. Working our show is Doris Powell from Rome, Pennsylvania. We welcome Doris back this afternoon. We enjoy her judging. She's worked here at our Big E, judging various shows several times over the course of her career. She's judged from coast to coast and at various national shows in Louisville. So at this time, we're going to hear her results.
Good afternoon. In this AOB wool show, it's kind of difficult to judge because we've got two totally different kind of sheep here. The ram that I'm starting the class with, a big framey Columbia ram, a ram that's got some extension up through the front end. He stands very well on those feet and legs. He's got some thickness down through his top. Just a very complete kind of a ram. The Jacob sheep that I've got in second place, another ram that you really have to appreciate him for its overall length of body. He's supposed to be a smaller frame kind of a sheep. He's got a very uniform fleece from front to rear, and his horns are very symmetrical. Two very nice rams. Thank you.
Congratulations, exhibitors. We weigh the top three in each of our classes, so both those yearling rams, we do need to get a weight, and then we're going to share that here with our spectators today. Chuck Simmons, congratulations on your reserve champion fleece. If you could just get around that Ken Wolf guy up in your neighborhood. If you haven't seen the fleeces, folks, they're some really outstanding. The gentleman in the gray t-shirt here in the show ring, gray shirt, had our reserve grand champion fleece overall. Those are over here on display on the other side of the fiber nook here, we call it. That's the wood building right here behind us. There's about 80 fleeces over there. Those are now up. You can go over and slip over and buy one if you'd like. There's also a large fleece show coming up in New York called the New York Bred Ewe Show and Sale. And we have catalogs. A lot of these breeds, including Columbias that are out here in the ring right now, are in that sale. So if you'd like to pick up a sale catalog, we have those. There are magazines over here on the table, plus our show programs. They have a yellow jacket on them. Come on over. You can see and follow along. our breeds here today. You'll notice each of these exhibitors have a number on their hip. That's their exhibitor number. That corresponds to the information that we have in the programs. And if you'd like to find out the pedigree of one of these animals, you can follow along, look that number up, and see how old it is, who the breeder was, who the exhibitor is. Find out who its mother and father is. So we try to keep you informed here at the Eastern States. And then, of course, in this class of three, we're going to weigh all three of these when this class is finished. Now, in our yearling ram class, our first place honors went to Cruet Sheep Farm from Findlay, Illinois, on Cruet 4-7. He was the son of Cruet 1112 out of a key dam and weighed 276 pounds. Our runner-up in that class was Michaela Crafty of Winchton, Massachusetts, with Crafty Farm 129 Jeff. And he was out of Crafty Farm Patty and dammed by Monkey. And that ram weighed 66 pounds. That was a Jacob. The first place ram was a Columbia. Bev Borsema, no smiling and smirking.
In this fall ram lamb class, starting the class with a very nicely balanced ram, a ram that has some extension up through that front end. When he moves out very nicely on those feet and legs, and when you open that fleece, it's very uniform and white from front to rear. The ram that I have in second place, another ram that closely follows the pattern of my first place ram, a ram that's maybe carrying a tad more wool than what I've got in my top placing ram, but another ram that you have to appreciate for the overall length of body and the uniformity of fleece from front to rear. The ram that I've got in third place, another ram that has a lot of extension up through the front end, a ram that just doesn't have as much body mass as what I've got in my top two rams, and not the uniformity of fleece from front to rear that I have in those top two rams. Thank you.
Congratulations, exhibitors, on a nice class of senior ram lambs. those of you following along our show here, we bring the sheep up here to the ringside. We check the ear tags to make sure it's the right animal. Then we line them up in class to the judge's benefit, where we put the older animals are to his or her right, to the youngest, which would be to the left. So that gives them an opportunity to get an idea of the age of the animals and then use that evaluation, the size and overall power and muscle of the animal to get an idea how well they compare from one to another. We do have two different breeds in here. The larger breeds, the tan breeds, that's the Columbias. Over here on our left side are Jacobs. And our oldest animal in this class is January 4. The youngest here was born April 4th. Here's the placings in our senior Ram Lamb class. First place went to Cruet Sheep Farm of Findlay, Illinois. Ring number 114, he weighed in at 216 pounds. He was Cruet 9 out of Misty Williams, 1326. Our runner-up Ram Lamb in the class went to ring number 116, exhibited by Keith Stumbo family, Down Valley Farm from Honey Eye, New York, on Travail 1445, and he was sired by Fry 1136. Our second place Down Valley Ram weighed 217. In third place was Cruet Sheep Farm with Cruet 5-10, also out of the Williams 1326 Ram, and he weighed 193.
in this spring ram lamb class. I was starting the class with a very nicely balanced ram, a ram that when you get your hands on him, he's very thick made down through that top, carries out very well down through that lower leg. And when he moves out on his feet and legs on the move, he just moves and walks very smoothly. The ram that I've got in second place, another ram, maybe a little tad more extension up through the front end than what I've got in my top placing ram, but a ram that just doesn't maybe walk quite as well, move out quite as well on those feet and legs as what I've got in my top placing ram. The ram that I've got in third place is a very eye-appealing ram when you profile this lamb from the side, a ram that just not quite as much of him today as what I've got in my top two rams, a ram that just doesn't move out as nicely on those feet and legs as what I've got in my top lambs. The next lamb I've got, a lamb that you really have to appreciate this lamb for his fleece, a fleece that's very uniform from front to rear, a lamb that's a very level-topped lamb, but a lamb that just doesn't move quite as well. He's kind of piecey when you put him together. He's just a little weaker behind those shoulders than what I've got in my top three lambs. We come down here to the Jacob sheep. It's just kind of not fair to be showing these sheep against these great big Columbia ewes, taking nothing away from them. They're a lot younger lambs, and they just haven't got quite the size and scale to compete, but nothing wrong with these lambs here today either. Thank you.
Congratulations, exhibitors. We'll weigh these first three, and then those of you that have entries in our pair class may work your way over here to the ringside, please. We'll weigh these top three rams, share the information while we line up our pair class. We want to recognize one of the exhibitors that we have here in the show ring this afternoon, and that's Bev Borsma. Yeah, you. And last year, you won the Shepherd's Award here for our week two. We appreciate you bringing it back, and we never had a chance to congratulate you. And let's put our hands together and congratulate Bev Borsma on a job well done last year here at the Big E. In our junior ram lamb class, first place honors went to the Keith Stumbo family of Honey Eye, New York. Ring number 119 weighed 195 pounds on Stumbo 15-3, and he was sired by Bach 194. In second place, also from the Down Valley Farm on ring 121 was Stumbo 15-23, also out of Bach 194. That ram weighed 200. In third place was Steve Hampson of Shirley, Massachusetts. Ring number 120 on Hampson 504, also out of the Buck 1-1 ram. He weighed 183. In fourth place was Steve Hampson with ring 122 on Hampson 505 out of Buck 1-1. Fifth place honors went to ring 125 from Michaela Caffey of Winchendon, Massachusetts on Caffey Farm 160 Rocker. And 126 rounded out the class from Michaela Caffey on Caffey Farm Splitter. And those following along in the book this afternoon, the placings will read from top down one with a weight of 195, three at 183, two at 200, four, five, and six. Our pair of ram lamb class was won by Cruet Sheep Farm of Findlay, Ohio. Our second place pair of ram lambs went to the Keith Stumbo and family flock of Honey Eye, New York. Third place honors were lambs bred by Steve Hampson of Massachusetts and Michaela Caffey, rounded out the class in fourth. All right, we want to recognize our contestants here competing for our grand champion ram hunters here of our all of the breeds wool division. We're going to start out here introducing the yearling ram to the judges. Right is from Cruet Sheep Farm of Illinois on the first place yearling ewe. Crafty Farm from Massachusetts had the runner-up yearling ram. Our first and second place senior ram lambs, first place honors went to Cruet Sheep Farm of Illinois. And the runner-up from the Down Valley Farm of New York. And our junior ram lamb class, first and second place each went to Down Valley Farm.
I think we've got some nice rams out here in this champion AOB drive, even though we've only got Columbia's out here but we've got a yearling ram up there. He's got a lot of extension up through the front end. He's a very level-topped, long-sided ram. He moves out nicely on those feet and legs. We've got a fall lamb, another very long-sided ram, a ram that you really have to appreciate him when you open that fleece. It's very white and bright and uniform from front to rear. And we've got a spring ram lamb here that you have to appreciate the way that when he moves out on his feet and legs, he walks very smoothly and he's got a very nice fleece. Today, I'm going to use this senior ram lamb for my champion ram. I just think a very nicely put together ram. For my reserve champion, I'm going to go back and I'm going to use my second place senior ram lamb. I think he closely follows the pattern of my champion. Just two very nice senior ram lambs. Thank you.
Congratulations to Cruet Sheep Farm of Illinois with their grand champion ram. Congratulations also to Down Valley Farm with their reserve grand champion. And again, those were out of the senior ram lamb class. folks, for a lot of exhibitors, this is a joyful moment. In the ring, those of you that are watching around our ringside and in the fine print and the rules and regulations here of the Big E catalog, it says that any exhibitor whose sheep gets away from him in the ring has to buy ice cream at the end of the week, sometime along the line there. And we've got our first candidate, our first guilty soul. We always let their conscience be the guide. And if Tom Collier's still in the barn, he knows he bought.
In this yearling U class, I think I've got a very nicely balanced U to start the class with, a U that's got a lot of extension up through the front end. When she moves out very nicely on those feet and legs. When you get your hands on her, she's a very thick-topped kind of a U that carries out very square out over that rump. the ewe that I've got in second place, another very long-sided ewe, a ewe that's got a lot of thickness down, very square out over that rump area, maybe not quite as much extension up through the front end as my top-placing ewe, but a ewe that you really have to appreciate for the uniformity of fleece from front to rear. The ewe that I've got in third place, perhaps a little taller made kind of a ewe, but a ewe that just gives up some of that total dimension down through that top and out over that rump area compared to our top two ewes. The next ewe I've got, a ewe that is a very clean made ewe up through the front end. She's stands, she profiles very nicely. She's just not as long from that last rib back as what I've got in my top three ewes. The next ewe I've got, another ewe that's a very long-sided ewe, a ewe that's got some extension once again up through the front end, but a ewe that just gives up some of that uniformity of fleece from front to rear compared to our top four ewes. Thank you.
That was a powerful class of yearling ewes from top to bottom. Those of you who are not getting your ewes weighed would like to go on and line up your pair entries at this time. We are ready for our pair of yearling ewe class. Here's the placings on that yearling ewe class. First place honors went to Gary Neese of Gosport, Indiana. Ring number 134 on Travail 1421, a daughter of Travail 516. She weighed 281. The second place yearling ewe in class, ring number 140, was from the Keith Stumbo flock down Valley Farm of Honeyoy, New York. Ring number 140. On Travail 1414, she weighed 244. The third place yearling ewe in the class was an entry from Steve Hampson of Shirley, Massachusetts on ring 137 with wrench 1437 and a daughter of Fry 1030. She weighed 239. In fourth place was Down Valley Farm from New York, ring number 136 on Stumbo 1441. Fifth place honors were ring 133 from Cruet Sheep Farm on Cruet 413 and a daughter of Cruet 1112. Sixth place also to the Cruet Sheep Farm, ring 132 on Cruet 440 out of Steve Hole 968. In seventh place was Steve Hampson, ring 135 with Pitt Family Columbia 715 and a daughter of Wollaston Hume, 983. Our eighth place yearling ewe in class was an entry from Michaela Craffey of Winchendon, Massachusetts, ring 141 on Craffey Beast, 130. And rounding out the class was Michaela Crappy on tank. And reading from top to bottom on that class, it will go 5-1 at 281 pounds, 7-4, 3 weighing 239, 6-9, and on the next page is 2 weighing 244 and 8. We have some exhibitors with a good distance to the show ring, so we're giving them the patience that they need to bring their animals up here to our show ring. Once again, if you're around the ringside here and have never visited our complex before, we have many things ongoing here at our Eastern States Exposition. We have just started a sheep shearing demonstration, which is just to the north end of the show ring, a little ways towards the butter sculpture, the fiber nook, if you'd like to buy some woolen products or kits or see how some things are made out of wool, be sure and walk through that wooden building. It's a lot of nice things in there to see. Also, if you'd like to buy some wool for spinning, they have fleeces for sale. The fleece show judging got done right here before lunch. And we do have the grand champion and reserve champion fleeces of all the divisions, plus the other fleeces, are now for sale. Later on today in the complex, we'll have our goat milking demonstration as well. And our class is complete. Bringing you up to date in the books, those of you that were recording our placings here, the Down Valley Farm of Honeyoy, New York, placed first. Second place in the pair of yearly new class went to Steve Hampson, and third place honors to the Cruett family of Illinois. Michaela Craffey of Winchendon, Massachusetts, rounded out the class in fourth, and reading down, it will go 3-2, 4 and 1.
In this fall ULAM class, I'll start the class with a very long-sighted U, a U that's got some extension up through the front end. When you get your hands on her, she's very long from that last rib back with a very uniform fleece. The U that I've got in second place, another U that's a very long in that hind saddle, a U that moves out nicely on those feet and legs. When you open that fleece, it's very white and bright. I got a U that's got a lot of extension here in the third hole. U that just maybe not quite as long as sighted U, gives up some of that total length in that loin area and not quite the uniformity of fleece that I've got in the top two U's. Thank you.
Here are the results of the senior ULAM class. First and second place honors both went to the Down Valley Farm from Honeyoy, New York. Ring numbers 149 and 148 respectively. They were twins to each other from the Keene flock, sired by Bach 190 and dammed by Keene 823. The class winner weighed 207 and the runner-up 203. Third place honors were won by Cruet Sheep Farm of Findlay, Illinois on Cruet 5-1 out of Williams 13-26.
in this class one junior ewe lamb class. We've got a very nice lamb to start the class with. A ewe that's got a lot of thickness down through her top. She's very square out over that rump with a lot of natural thickness down through that lower leg. The ewe lamb that I've got in second place, another ewe that has a lot of extension up through the front end. She's got a lot of body capacity there. Just not quite as long from that last rib back as what I've got in my top placing ewe. The ewe that I've got in third place, another ewe, a ewe that profiles very nicely. She's very long-sighted, just not quite the overall thickness or squareness out over that rump area and down through that lower leg is what I've got in my top two ewes. The next ewe I've got, another ewe, a ewe that tends to shorten up, not quite as long a sighted ewe, not quite the extension up through the front end that I have, but another ewe that you have to appreciate when you open that fleece. It's very uniform and very white from front to rear. Thank you.
Here's the placings on our Group 1 Junior Ewe Lamb class from our All of the Breeds division. The first place lamb in the class was exhibited by Cruet Sheep Farm, weighed in at 147. On crew at 522, she weighed 168. The second place lamb in class was exhibited by Gary Neese. Ring number 152 of Gosport, Indiana, with Troxel, 1504. And she was a daughter of Fry's Burnout and weighed 180. In third place was Steve Hampson from Shirley, Massachusetts, ring number 156, with Highway C 219 and sired by Charles and Louise Worm, 310. That lamb weighed 175. In fourth was Steve Hampson with Hampson's 501, ring number 153. Fifth place honors went to the Down Valley Farm of New York with ring 157 on Stumbo 1507. And rounding out the class was Michaela Craffey of Massachusetts with Craffey Farm Dodge. Reading down your book, it went two with a weight of 180. First at 168. Third, one down was four, then six, three at 175 and five.
In this class two, junior U lamb class, starting the class with a very nicely balanced U, a U that moves out very nicely on those feet and legs when she's on the move. And when you open that fleece, it's very uniform from front to rear. few lamb I have in second place, a lamb that is a very long-sided lamb, a lamb that has a lot of thickness down through that top that carries on down through that lower leg, another lamb that moves out very nicely on those feet and legs. The lamb that I've got in third place, a lamb that has a lot of extension up through the front end, she profiles very nicely. She's just not quite as long from that last rib back as what I've got in my top two ewes. The blue-faced Leicester ewe that I have here in fourth place, another very nicely balanced ewe, a ewe that's very long-sided. When you open that fleece, it's very uniform from front to rear. The next lamb that I've got, another lamb that I'd really like to maybe change the fleece on this lamb to have her go up any higher today, but a lamb that's got some thickness down through that top. The next lamb that I've got here, the little Jacob's lamb, a lamb that you really have to appreciate for the fleece on this lamb. It's a very uniform fleece from front to rear. Just doesn't have the age to compete with these other ones today. Thank you.
Here's the placings on our Group 2 Junior Ewe Lamb class. First place went to Cruet Sheep Farm of Illinois with Cruet 530, and she weighed 161 pounds. Second place honors, ring number 158 from the Stumbo flock in New York with a lamb weighing 180. Third place to ring 150, shown by Cruet Sheep Family of Illinois. Ring number 150 weighed 137. In fourth was ring 161 from Elora Chapin of Smiling Sheep Farm in Milton, New Hampshire with Chapin Tiana 165. Fifth place to Elora Chapin, ring 162 on Chapin Taylor Swift. Sixth place to Michaela Craffey of Massachusetts on Craffey Gazelle.
says bad.
We want to recognize our lineup here of class winners and runner-ups from each of the classes and pick a grand champion you overall here in our All of the Breeds division. Our first place yearling you was exhibited by Gary Neese of Gosport, Indiana. The runner-up in that class was a ewe from the Keith Stumbo and family flock of New York. Our senior ewe lamb class winner and runner-up were both from the Down Valley flock, the Stumbo family in New York. Our first place junior ewe lamb, group one, was won by Cruet Sheep Farm of Illinois and Gary Neese from Indiana with the runner-up. And in our junior class, first place went to Cruet Sheep Farm from Illinois. And our second place group two ewe lamb was from the Down Valley flock of New York.
I think these exhibitors need a round of applause for a nice set of females here this afternoon. We've got some really nice sheep out here. The classes were were maybe small, but they were very powerful for the most part. Today, I'm going to go up here and I'm going to use this yearling ewe for my champion ewe. That was a very strong class all the way from the top, from the bottom. She's going to be our champion ewe today. It gets a little closer for me for our reserve champion. Like I say, the yearling ewe class was a very powerful class. The second place yearling ewe is a very good female. She's very long-sighted. She's got some thickness down through her top. I come back here. This junior ewe lamb, a class one, is a very nicely balanced ewe. She's got some extension up through the front end with a very white, bright fleece. Today, I'm going to use this class one junior ewe lamb for our reserve champion. Thank you.
Congratulations to Gary Neese from Indiana with the grand champion ewe and Cruett Sheep Farm from Illinois with the reserve grand champion ewe. And our junior show champion and reserve champion ewes went to Elora Chapin. And she is going to be bringing them out at this time. Alora's champion ewe is the ewe on the right. And her runner-up is the young lamb here on her left. Congratulations. Here's the placings in our exhibitors' flock. First place honors went to the Down Valley Farm of New York. Second place was a group exhibited by Cruett Sheep Farm of Illinois. In third place was Steve Hampson of Shirley, Mass. And our fourth place group were from Michaela Craffey of Winchendon, Massachusetts. The next class to be judged is our breeders' flock. We have two contestants. All five of these must be bred and owned by the exhibitor. So if you have pulled out, we are going to leave our animals placed the way they stand. Cruett Sheep Farm 1 and Michaela Craffey in 2. How you doing there, Steve? Showmanship, I like that. No swinging of the arm in front of it. She wants to go out the way she came in anyway. We do have three get of sires. While we're wrestling you out here, we're going to give you our trivia. We've got good help. We've got a sheep superintendent that'll do anything to help the exhibitors. Make sure you have the right animals, too. This is our Get of Sire class. Those of you around the ringside here will probably notice the structural similarity of all these animals, the similar breed character, the similar shape to their bodies. All four of these out here were sired by, in each group, the same ram. That is the criteria. It's called the Get of Sire class, so we're judging the job the ram did at home. And you'll see some variations here, two different breeds represented. The two breeds on the judge's right are Columbia's, the breeds to the left are Jacob's. And they are the four-horned animals there. I don't know if you can see them closely, but they do have four horns on their head. Our class-winning group is going to be the Cruett Sheep Farm from Illinois. Down Valley from New York had the runner-up, and Michaela Craffey of Massachusetts had the third-place group. Keith Stumbo, we're going to give you guys a little trivia. 10 years ago, we're going to see if you can remember who had the champion rams and ewes and who was the premier exhibitor and breeder. It was the Columbia show only. We didn't have Jacobs in that class. Dave Cook was the judge. Dave Cook judged. And one of our winners is here in the ring, so... He says, that'd be me. But do you remember what me won? Keith Stumbo, you had a junior, or no, you had the U on a yearling U. You had champion reserve on your U's. And Richard and Mary Ann Johnson, Highline Farm, had the champion ram on a junior buck lamb. Weighed 179. Steve, you want to go get back and get that U? We have one more contestant coming up the line. There are so many sheep here this year. This barn is packed from end to end. Hampson, what are you doing with your sheep? Our judge at this time is selecting the best fleece overall here in our All of the Breeds Wool Division. And what we mean by all of the breeds, it's breeds of sheep that do not have quite enough animals for their own breed. So in this particular class, the animal that our judge is looking at now is called a Blue-Faced Leicester. The larger framed animals are from the Columbia breed, and the four-horned animal, the smaller lamb here in the center of the class, is a Jacob. And if you look around the barn up here behind our announcer station are flags with different breeds of sheep that are either here in the barn now or have been in the barn. We had 800 head of sheep in the barn last week. We're close to that again or more this week. So look around the barn, see if you can identify these different breeds of sheep, and come back tomorrow. We have a huge day. We have 112 Border Leicesters for their national show entered. There are 155 entries in the National Tuna Show. So you'll be able to see sheep judging from about 8:30 all day long. Also, once the first breed is completed, we will have our second week of lead laying competition, and that's a fashion show with sheep involved, so it's quite nice. Steve Hampson with the best fleece winner. And folks, we do want to get pictures of the champions and reserves. Key Stumbo, we should keep a couple of yours. That's a long way down there to go back and get them. This time we do need to get our pictures of all of our champions and reserves, and this will complete our sheep show today. We need a representative of the Cruet Sheep Farm. And in a very close decision, very, very close decision, Cruet Sheep Farm wins both the Premier Exhibitor and Premier Breeder Awards. Let's give them a nice round of applause. Cruet Sheep Farm from Findlay, Illinois.